Glad you're feeling good. Hope everything works out for you.
Hello. I'm sorry, you're what now?
Peter from the diocese.
You got to speak up, Peter.
I am calling from the diocese in an effort to bring, I believe, some enlightenment to you. The problem.
This is a work.
Oh, you don't think I know that this is a work? Like some dude from the diocese is going to be calling me. Go ahead, sir. I'm interested to hear what you got to say.
In any event, I believe the young lady in Jacksonville just carries a Christian ethos with her.
Christian ethos.
She does.
I like that term.
While she
number has, one with all Christian ethoses. Not to be confused with any Ethiopians or any other. No, I'm not. That maybe listen to the show. It's the show for the Diocese of America. Go ahead, sir. I'm sorry to interrupt. I'm so rude.
I'm sorry to have interrupted you.
Go ahead.
Phone call, perhaps.
I'm sorry.
I find that her turning to another program for her employment and yet retaining goodwill for that which she has left, yes, does.
She's truly blessed, is she not, sir? Yes, she is. She's blessed because my fat ass is employing her right now, but not for long!
I'm shocked by your outburst.
This guy's great.
I love this guy.
I call you simply because the diocese secretary informed me that this is a program I should listen to. It's always wise, I hope you understand, to know where the evil lies and to know what the evil thinks and does.
Yes. Why am I considered evil?
Yes.
I believe in God. I believe in Jesus. I believe that he died for my sins. I believe in all that good stuff.
You know that that's curious you mentioned. I find that your Midwest upbringing... You know, you've had your mother on the program before.
Yeah, Janie. And, you know, I find it very interesting that you know all of this stuff.
It's wise to know the enemy, sir.
I'm not the enemy, so let's get that straight.
In the eyes of the Lord, the teachings of Matthew the Apostle, I think we can find your behavior, your thought processes, your demeanor involving the opposite sex is indeed...
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry?
I said the opposite sex, that's what I'm talking about. Straight work down style. 21 years old, been over on all fours. The big bizzy will be shaking in the wind. DNA. Booby shaking in the wind. I'm gonna crank her down to a nub. Gonna pizzle out before I shoot my sizzy.
I'm continually amazed at the rhetoric you speak. Do you understand?
I'm a prophet.
Certainly. My friend, you are the farthest thing from prophecy. May I invite the entire group there, the fellows I hear this morning, to come worship.
Invite us all you want.
Won't you come down here and worship for us? You bring your worshiping gimmick down here to the studio. We'll do a whole day of Peter.
Get a fold-up confessional you could bring down here.
You got like one of those portable confessioner gimmicks? What's that, Peter?
I can assure you, my friend, and as witnesses, Ned and whoever else you have seated among you, I suspect in a round table, again emulating our Lord and his apostles, that I would never set foot in a room where you might be.
I'm asking you to come. I'm reaching for you to help me. And so you being an extension of the Lord Jesus Christ, you need to come help me.
You're
I'm
calling
asking,
out the Lord.
I'm asking you. Come.
Yes, Lord.
Come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant.
Lay your healing hands upon me, Father.
Sir, I don't
let it ride.
So you Ned like just told God to let it ride.
Who is this other fellow, may I ask?
Ned's the older gentleman of the show. Ned. He is a 61-year-old gentleman that is part of my program. And he, you know, is crazy, quite frankly.
Ned, may I address an inquiry to you?
Yes, you may, Father.
I am not a friend, nor did I expose myself to be a priest.
Expose himself? That's not the first time.
Nor did I expose myself to be anything but what I am.
A gay man?
No, in fact, this is the issue I wish to address. It is written.
It is written.
That man shall not lie with another man.
Yeah, that's why I always maintain a standing position.
All of you find that funny.
Yeah. It's hilarious.
Perhaps you've shared the same bed.
No.
It sounds like you have there, Light in the Loafers, boy.
The problem with religion is that it's a scam.
People like you.
And the problem with religion is that it's not talking, it's people like you talking to us rather than people like Eminem talking to us. If it's people that can talk to us and put religion in our type of language, then we understand religion more. If people would be a little bit more hip on religion, then we would, the kids and us younger people would be able to grasp it a little bit more if it was put in our type of genre.
You
and I have that genre, if you will listen. Will you listen? I have a thing that my good friend Eminem, the rapper, did, explaining the way Bible stories, according to Eminem,
you'll burn in hell,
can be grasped by the young people of our society far easier than all these big words you're using. Can I play it for you? Will you listen?
Eternally in the flames of hell shall he rot and perish.
Will you listen?
I enjoy Bible passages.
Okay, here we go.